Hi everyone, this is Clear Bakhmut and good morning. In my previous video, I've shown how to use Cypress Recurse plugin to retry typing into the input field that is reset by the application several times in the first 300 milliseconds. If you do not use Cypress Recurse, the test is flaky because the test is accidentally hitting change input. Right? Let me show it again. Notice part of the first input disappears, the input loses the first characters, first word, and so on. I've shown how to use Cypress Recurse because that approach tries to type into the input field and then checks if the input has that value. If the value changes because the application resets the input, it clears the input, tries again. So that's nice, but it still doesn't solve the original problem. Your application allows the user to type something into this input box before it is ready. It could be not ready for many reasons. Maybe it's re-rendering things, maybe it's loading the data and then re-renders the field, clearing it. Whatever it is, the problem is it's not the test run. The test runner just sees the input field, it's enabled, tries to type it in. So you have to know what your application is doing and when it is ready to accept the user actions. So the real solution here is not to even use Cypress Recurse. Cypress Recurse is a backstop, right? A workaround. The real solution is to say, my input box will be disabled by default because I know that at the start, my application will reset it. Only after it is done, I'm gonna enable, let's say after 300 milliseconds. Let's write the function enable text. It will grab the same input box, and then it will remove the attribute disabled. Let's see how this works. I'm going to rerun the original test with recurse, and it worked. Actually, this is not original. This is the one with recurse. Now, notice what's happening here. It got the input box and tried to clear it. Now, this clear command waits for the input box to be enabled, and then it types hello there. By this time, the application is ready to accept the input, doesn't clear the field anymore, and it succeeds on the first try. Now, we can remove this completely and only run the original test that just gets the input box and try to type. The type command, just like clear command in Cypress, waits for the input box to be enabled before it types. Let's show it a little bit better. Let's say we enable the input box after 2 seconds. Let's rerun the test. And notice how it's waiting for the input box to be enabled. And only once it is enabled, it starts typing. Again, wait to type. Box is enabled, then it types. So please, when you deal with flaky tests, look at what your application is doing. It probably is doing something and the test runner is unaware of it. And if test runner can type, that means the user can type as well. And that means the user will experience flaky application behavior. So disable the input by default and remove it, this attribute, when the application is ready to work.